So in this lecture, we will discuss on primary nucleotide and protein structure database. We know that the sequence database stores the information about the sequence, whereas the structural database stores the information about the structure. So if we take the nucleotide, then the structure of the tRNA, the structure like zDNA, or the bDNA. So the orientation, the coiling, the folding of the DNA, how they are coiled, how the structure is formed, comes in the structure database. Whereas if we take the protein structure database, then the structure of the primary structure, secondary structure, tertiary structure, quaternary structure, domains, motifs, folding, hydrophilic, hydrophobic regions. So all this information comes in the protein structural database. So in this lecture, we will discuss on primary nucleotide and protein structural database. The first database is the nucleic acid database. It contains the information about the structure of the nucleic acid and complex assemblies which are experimentally determined. Here the complex means the nucleic acid with proteins or with metals ions or with drug. So they are forming the complex. Nucleic acid with proteins, nucleic acid with metals, nucleic acid with drugs. So the database stores the information about the nucleic acid and complex formed with the nucleic acid. And the data are experimentally determined. The second database is the protein data bank. It stores the information about the 3D structure of large biomolecules. So large biomolecules like the proteins, the nucleic acid, the peptide, the complex formed with the proteins and the nucleic acid. So the data coming from the data coming in the protein data bank is from the X-ray crystallography technique or from the NMR or electron microscopy technique. So these three techniques, X-ray crystallography, NMR and electron microscopy, are the technology which helps in determining the 3D structure of large biomolecules. The third database is the Cambridge Structural Database. It is the only world's repository which holds the information about the organic and metal organic crystal. So the data of organic and metal organic crystal is validated and curated. We know that the validated and curated, curated means which is experimentally and manually checked. So the data is coming from the X-ray and neutron diffraction techniques. So the organic and metal organics means the molecules which are not nucleic acid or proteins, apart from the these two, nucleic acid and proteins. The information is stored in the Cambridge structural database. For the example, like the drug, so for like the ATP or other carbohydrates. So these types of data are stored in the Cambridge structural database. Okay, so now we will first visit to the nucleic acid database. So this is how the nucleic acid database web page is shown. So we have several options for searching. We can search with the DNA, we can search with the RNA, we have the advanced searches, we have feature tools also, which you like the RNA 3D motif. With it we can search for the hairpin loop and other feature tools also. So and same search with DNA, search with RNA and advanced search, which we have seen in the below also search structure. So we can search with the nucleic acid data bank ID also and with the PDB ID also. So we will search with raw search. We will go for the raw search and search with the DNA. Let's see what comes. Okay, so here are the filters. Here are the filters of polymer protein function. If it is a complex, then structural features, like we want the single stranded or A DNA, B DNA, Z DNA, and the experimental method of determination, like the nucleic acid determined with the X-ray crystallography technique or with the NMR technique. So here is the filters. So let's click on the first so that we can understand the results or the analysis in the we have the NDB ID and the PDB ID. So both the IDs are the same. So let's see, because NDB IDs and PDB ID are, as the NDB and PDB are integrated data bank, we can access the NDB from the PDB data bank also. So the results is that title is given, the molecular description is given, that how many chains are in it. So we can say that it has two chains, A and B. The deposition date, the release date, the structural keyword that it is Z double helix, the primary citation, the paper which gives the structure, the experimental information that it is coming from the X-ray diffraction, then the other information. We can download the structure in the PDB format or in the CIF format, in the XML format. So these are the different formats we can download according to our need. Here are the structure of the determined structure of the nucleic acid. So we can see this is the nucleic acid structure. So this is how the DNA is searched. So we will go back and we will see the RNA structure also. So we will click on the RNA. Okay, so same results, same web page, same type of web results are shown. So we will search the first, that is the 6ZDP. Okay, so same results will be shown, that it is title, its description, the dates, the new. We can see that it is a complex. Why? Because it is having the nucleic acid sequence and the protein sequence. So let's see the image first. So we can see that the orange part is a RNA and the green part is a protein. So it is a complex between the RNA and protein. If we see here also, we can see that protein sequence and the nucleic acid sequence. So if we click, then we can see that chain B is the nucleic acid and chain A is the protein sequence. So here is the protein sequence is given, the primary citation, the paper from which the data is coming, the technique used is the X-ray diffraction. So this is how the data in the NDB nucleic acid database is stored. So now we will visit the second database, that is protein data bank. So this is how the web page of the protein data bank is visualized. So if we concentrate here, we can see that it is an integrated database of the PDB, EM data resource, NDB, the nucleic acid database which we have visited, the world wide protein data bank. So if we want to access the nucleic acid or the protein, we can simply come to the PDB as it is an integrated database. So we can search with the PDB ID or we can search with the name. So we will first try to do the raw search. We will go for the R-kinase TTK search. So here is the additional structure, and if we go down, we can see that we have the crystal structure of TTK kinase domain. So we will click on it and we will see the results. So this is how the results are come. Here also we can see the filters are given that we want from the Homo sapiens. Then the method, then the taxonomy is given, then the experimental methods will be given, then the polymer entry will be given, then the resolution, the release date. So we can use any of the, or we can use the required filters. We have used the one filter that says the Homo sapiens, which having the 5 entries. So let's click on it. Okay, so we will, this is the PDB ID, 3DBQ is a PDB ID. So let's see what it is. So it is a crystal structure of TTK kinase domain. So these are the scientists which in the paper worked on the determining the structure of the TTK kinase domain. It is the release date, the general name, the method used, the organism, and the molecular name. Micromolecule name. So we will click on the ID. This is how the results are visualized for the PDB. So let's see one by one. So first we will see the structure of the PDB, this kinase. Okay, so this is how the structure is graphical is seen. So we can rotate the structure, we can select the amino acids. So it's all according to our need. So this is to visualize. Now we will see one by one. So 3D BQ is the ID, the name is given, the date of issue is given, that in this paper we will get the information about the ID, about the paper, the classification that it is coming from the transferase family, the organism, the expression system, that this kinase is expressed in this particular expression system. Then the experimental data, that it is coming from the X-ray, the resolution, and other information, R value, this is determining the quality of the data. So the data can be graphically view here, that if the bars are more closer to the red, then the structure is having less reliability. If the bars are more towards the blue, then the reliability is better. So we will click on the full report and we will see it. We have opened in the another tab. Let's move down. So this is the literature. If we want to cite, if we are using the particular structure, we can cite this paper. Okay, so this is the entry, that it is having only one chain, which is of 343 sequence length, and the organism is Homo sapiens. The image we have already seen. Then this is the graphical representation of the sequence in the linear form. Then again the same information is given which we have seen above. Then the software, the what software they have used for determining the structure. Then okay, so this is how the information in the PDB is given. So if we want to use this structure for our drug designing or for our simulations, molecular dynamic simulations, then we can download this structure. For download, we can download the file in the PDB format or in the FASTA sequence, and or the other structure formats according to our need. We can display the file. Let's display the FASTA sequence. Okay, so this is the FASTA sequence. You can see that it is having the chain A, and only a single chain structure it is. Here is the ID, the name, and this is the PDB sequence. Oh, sorry, this is the FASTA sequence of the protein. So let's display the PDB also. This is the PDB format. Okay, so this is how the PDB's format is. It is. So here is the header. So the name of the protein family, the date, the ID, and other information. Then the each atom information, here is the amino acid. Here is the list of amino acid. Then the position of the amino acid, and the each atom, like the this is the nitrogen. If I give this small introduction to this, that the it is starting from the atom, the first atom, it is the nitrogen coming from the ASN amino acid of chain A, and this is the X, Y, and Z latitudes. Then the second is the carbon alpha of ASN protein chain A, and this is the X, Y, and Z. So this is how the PDB file is arranged. Each atom coordinates each atom with coordinate it's given. So this is how the PDB file is visualized. So now we will see the full report of the quality of the particular structure. Let's click on the full report. Okay. So this is the how the full report is quality of the report quality of the structure is given. So overall quality at a glance, so we can see the overall quality in first place, that if it is more if it is more closer to the red bar, then the quality is worse. It is if the bars are more closer to the blue, then the better the quality. So we can see that the quality of chain, the red is, which is the 6%. So the 6% information, initial 6% information is of less reliable quality, whereas the 39% is of reliable, and accordingly the color code is given. Then if we come down, then we can see the residue property, each amino acid prediction. So we see that the green colors are of great or of more reliable as compared to the other color. So this is how the visualization at the each amino acid is given. And the other quality parameters are also given. So this is how the report of the quality of the structure is given. So this is how we use the PDB database. So now we will visit the third database, that is Cambridge database. The Cambridge structural database. Okay. So this is how the web page of the Cambridge database is visualized. So we have two options, that we can deposit the structure, we can access the structure. So our primary aim is to access the structure. So we will click on the access structure. Then we can access the database by giving the identifiers, like the, if we can give the CCDC number, or the we can give the Cambridge database ID, the we can give the compound name, we can give the date of issue, when the structure of the data, or the structure of the molecule is released, the author name, the general name, and the year. So we will go for the compound name search. So let's search for a compound. It is a COVID times and it is a COVID time, and we can search for the remdesivir structure. So we will generally select the name of the drug, and we will try to search that it is present or not in the database. So we will paste in the compound name. Okay, remdesivir. Okay, now we will search. Okay, so several results are given. If we see what are the information. So this is the deposition number, this is the Cambridge ID, then the general name, then the compound name, and the synonyms, like what are the other name of the compound, and the drug bank ID. So we can get this structure from the drug bank also, drug bank, or from the PubChem ID, or from the Zinc database. Or these three databases are the drug databases. For the searching for the small molecules database. So let's it's coming from the Royal Society of Chemistry General. So let's see what are the information inside it. So here is the structure of the chemical, 2D structure, and here is the 3D structure. If we zoom, same information is given, that coming from the ID, the scientist name, the other name, the data bank ID, the date of coming, the crystallography by the affiliation, then the other data also. So we can see that it is a 3D structure. I am moving the structure with the mouse. So we can download this structure for our drug discoveries also. We can download the current entry, download all selected entries, and other we can download it according to our need. In the next lecture, we will deep dive into the secondary structure database.